Hello, my name is Mauricio Muñoz, and I will be the teacher for the course unit Research and Design Methodology during the Block 1B for the Bachelor Program of Industrial Engineering and Management. This is the first of a series of videos that will introduce the topics of the course. We will get in depth into the theory, and of course, I would like to start with a brief presentation. Together with the help of Gerald Jonker and Harm Klosterman, we are the group of teachers that will provide support during the course unit. Also, we have a team of teaching assistants, Evelyn, Fayez, Shiresh, Irene, and Lars. They will take the role of informants during the second part of the course unit, in the synthesis case. But also, they will bring support during the TVL sessions. If there are comments or questions that certainly were not answered, or which answer is not really in the syllabus, or the answer is not really connected to the documentation or this series of videos, then you can always send us an email. And you can make use of the account for the course unit, rdm-im@ruch.nl. This is our official channel for communication together with the Nestor tool. Let's start the course unit with a quote, of course. Each research project aims to provide knowledge, insights, and information that contribute towards solving a problem. And here the key word is problem. When we have a desired situation, and such situation is different from our current situation, well, normally we claim that we have a problem. But this is not only connected to practical problems of engineering fields, but also we aim to address fundamental questions, how to bridge that knowledge gap. This quote is connected to the, or is coming from the book, Designing a Research Project. And the book is the second edition, and was written, of course, by Piet Verschuren and Hans Torenbart. The course unit is divided in two main steps, the conceptualization or conceptual design, and the operationalization of the research project, this research or design project, in the technical research design step. First, we answer what, why, and how much. And later on, we will address the questions how, where, and when. Now, the idea, of course, is to design properly an objective. That's the goal of the project. It's what we want to achieve. It's fed by all the information that you have gathered during the problem analysis. And certainly has to be connected to the desires of the stakeholders. Now, the objective. In parallel with the so-called research framework, a research framework is a sort of conceptualization of all the phases of the project. And also, we will explore the so-called chapter on conceptual modeling, or simply putting your ideas in conceptual maps. Now, the objective and the research framework will fit our so-called research questions. The objective is within the project context. As I said at the beginning, we need to understand the problem. And the questions, these questions that are coming directly from our objective and our research framework, these research or design questions, can always be divided into sub-questions. And these questions, of course, will have to be answered. And these questions will be answered with proper tools and methods. And where are we going to get such information about the tooling? Where are we going to get inspired by the methods? Of course, there is a theoretical framework. Mostly the framework will come from literature, will come from experience or of previous engineers or researchers. And this is one of the key elements, of course, of the course unit. We need to go to the literature. We need to explore journals. And I'm going to repeat this, believe me, almost in every video, because it's quite important to really be on the level, on the spectral level, in terms of the right literature that will inspire enough tools and methods that will answer the sub-questions, by which we will reach the objective. When we put all these elements together, objective, research framework, conceptual mapping, questions, sub-questions, then we say that we have defined and operationalized. And this is again, of course, connected to the conceptual design of designing actually a research project. This is coming, of course, from our observable phenomena, meaning that it's the context, the one that provides most of the required information to have properly designed an objective and to have properly designed research questions or design questions together with their sub-questions. That was a brief introduction for the first step on designing a research project. But there is this second step in the operationalization phase, the technical research design. Here we will address three main elements: our research strategy, research material, and research plan. And this is, of course, utilizing, following the jargon of the book. But feel free, of course, to make use of the jargon of the specialized literature that will fit actually your research plan. Now, if we go to strategy, there are some questions that we need to address. There are some elements that we need, of course, to define, whether this is depth or a wide range. What is the amount of data? What is the complexity of the data? What is the availability of the data? And of course, once we have defined such strategies, we need to say, okay, so what's my material? And when we see here research population, people, object, situations, documents, when we say, let's define the gathering techniques, of course, methods and tools, simulations, pilots, experimental design, prototyping, rapid prototyping, meaning that it's not only talking about the nature and the complexity of the data, but it's also how are you going to gather such data. And again, this is not just tick boxing. It's getting inspired by actually real projects, because in principle you will work with actually real problems that were already solved, and you will work, of course, with fundamental questions that were already partially or totally answered. Meaning that this is connected, of course, to the TVL sessions, and it's also connected to the synthesis case. At the end, you need to provide a research plan. And this research plan is a so-called time schedule, or also we can mention it that is actually the Gantt chart. And we will see this chart, we will explore its possibilities, and hopefully you will make use of it, not only for the course unit, but also whenever you need to set up your own research project. So this is key, not only for academia, but of course this will be key once you are dealing with complex situations in your professional lives.